What up? It's the Trooper. Feels just like a Sunday. Just like a Sunday. It's two completely separate elevator banks right here next to each other. There's three, and there's two on the other side. Oh, we have a winner. On the south end of the strip today, not so far south as Mandalay Bay, but you know, Tropicana and the strip, we've got some food options down here. I mean, we got a lot of food options. You got your Panda Express, your Popeyes, your Square Pizza, your Shake Shack. You got your Crack Shack. Horrible mistake yesterday that I think today we make it right. So I've seen this thing on Twitter a couple of times already. So it must be a controversy, right? If you've seen it mentioned more than once. Something about a guy in the World Series of Poker who was tanking on a decision. I guess he was facing a bet and he was sitting there for a long time and then he reached into his stack and pulled some chips towards himself and then let them go and continued to think. And there seems to be a lot of people, apparently, that think that he did something wrong or that there should be a rule against that. That's insane. I am pretty disgusted by this desire to coddle poker players, especially, it almost seems like it's an online poker player thing because there are no You don't see each other in online poker. You know, there are no chips, you know, to think about or to count or to move around or to place into a pot. Not only do I not think that there should be a rule against what this guy did, I think that there are rules that shouldn't exist. There are some rules that I understand, some newer rules in poker, but in the old days it was like the Wild West, anything goes. You could say anything, you could do just about anything. For the record, you should be able to touch your chips. You should also be able to induce tells if you want to. What's wrong with that? Your whole job is to pay attention to other people, to other players, and figure out what they're thinking and what they're doing. You know, it's just like that situation that happened to me at Caesars a long time ago when I took a stack of 20 chips across the line and cut off 25, and the guy threw in a black chip instantly before I was even able to finish counting. I was gonna bet $100. I bet 25 instead because I didn't have anything. It was his fault. You know what I mean? Like, he gave out information before my action was complete. My action wasn't complete. Just because your mind is made up doesn't make your action complete. So if you think to yourself, I call, is the dealer supposed to just put the river card out after you just thought to yourself that you're gonna call the turn? No, you have to actually complete your action. You either have to say the words, I call, or you have to put chips into the pot or something. So it makes no sense. By the way, Pan Express, 100 times better than whatever Pan Asian is. I don't think I would eat Pan Asian for free, to be honest with you. Please remind me of that. I hope I don't accidentally eat it again 2 years from now. I walked over here to the Target. It's just like a half a block away. I'm gonna grab a coffee and then let's go play poker. p.m. The good news is I found a pretty good game at MGM Grand. The bad news is I got cooled pretty bad. After playing top pair and a flush draw on the flop very aggressively and then shoving the turn, the guy appeared to be this close to folding pocket kings on the turn. But he could have full pot kings, come on. I had 9-10 of spades, it was a 9 high, 2 spade flop. He led for 20 into like 5 people. 2 people folded, I made it 70, and he reluctantly, well it appeared that he reluctantly called. And on the turn he checked and I just put it in for 140, 160. And he called. But after that hand is when the cooler came down. There was a guy 2 seats to my right, apparently from Miami, who folded out of turn for 5 straight hours. Just didn't really seem to know or care how some of the basic rules of the game went. He raised early position to $6. And so with ace queen of clubs, I 3-bet it to $21. He called. We saw the flop heads up. The flop was ace queen 3 with 2 diamonds. Actually, I just misspoke. There was an overcall behind me pre-flop, so we did see it 3 ways. The guy checked. I bet $30. The guy folded, and the original villain, the $6 raiser, called. The turn card was three of spades. That put two diamonds and two spades, so it's ace, queen, 3-3. He led for 25. I raised to, I want to say 70. He called. The river was, I don't even remember what the river was. Long story short, he led for 25 again. Of course, I go all in for like 150 at this point. He calls. I immediately turn over ace queen. He rolls over pocket aces. That's cooler. It might not be a cooler against some people, but against this guy, it's a cooler. You know what though? I did like playing at MGM. Maybe it's because it was like, it's been a long time since I played there. So for the night, I am down 658. I have a feeling that I'm about to go on a tear. A tear, I said. I'm not talking about when you put something on the scale and push the tear button so it starts at zero from there. I'm not talking about that kind of tear. So that settles it. That settles November 14th, 2021. It's over. In just a few minutes, it's gonna be Monday. It's gonna be November 15th, 2021. Yo, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos, leave a comment down below. And by the way, it's quite possible that by the time you see this video, Lady Trooper, Sparkly Pops, Holiday Flavors might be dropping. Oh yeah, you're not gonna wanna miss these. I'm stoked, I can't wait to tell you about it. So remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. Didn't I say that already? Am I losing my damn mind? I'll see you next time. Believe it.